Hey, Hennefesh, it's the 9th of April, 2019. Oh man, there's so many things, so many insane things going on right now that just make you want to just cringe and you don't know which way to go, right? I mean, all these events happening in the world right now to keep the minds busy and people just yearning for a beer and their television, you know? But the fact of the matter is, there is a very serious spiritual war going on for your soul. And they're about to have some groundbreaking results come from a black hole hunting event horizon telescope. Now, this is crazy because the whole flat earth situation, right? The firmament. That's what you're looking into when you look up, okay? And it's like everything else of God. Even the angels seek to know this stuff. Even Satan, one of the angels, seeks to know these things because he doesn't know all these things. These black holes, and this just came to me as I was looking around today, are nothing more than the portals, if you will, of the sun and the moon and whatnot that are explained in Enoch. Okay? Now, Enoch is a legitimate book just based on the fact that it's mentioned all over the Bible. And this is where I came across this today, is in Jude. Okay? I was just led there. And it comes to where, you know, the wandering stars, whom is reserved the blackness of darkness forever. And Enoch also, the seventh from Adam, prophesied of these, saying, behold, the Lord cometh with 10,000s of his saints. Now, as far as dissecting this prophecy, I just see things that just come into my spirit that I'm like, wait a minute, there's something going on here. That they're wandering stars, okay, which we can refer to angels as stars, fallen angels, wandering stars, all these various characterizations, but we know that we're looking up at the hosts of heaven, but we're looking at it through a firmament, through a glass, through a sea of whatever God has there, because that's as far as you can go. I mean, they've even tried to shoot things through this stuff, you guys. I mean, you can look this stuff up yourself, but they literally shot nukes like almost 700 miles up into the space. They can't go any further. You can only go a certain distance, and that's it. Nothing goes any further. And that's the way it is. And these black holes, I believe, are just portals because they see them everywhere. And if you read Enoch, right, he talks about all the portals. You know, he was shown by the angel Uriel, you know, the first law of the luminaries. The luminary, the sun, has its rising in the eastern portals of the heaven and its setting in the western portals of heaven. And I saw six portals in which the sun rises and six portals in which the sun sets. The moon rises and sets in these portals. You see what I mean? There is so many things going on up there that when we're looking at it, it's like, I love images, but I don't have a lot pertaining to this. But basically, we're looking through here, and we see these luminaries and everything that's set in the firmament, but we don't know what we're looking at, absolutely. We really don't. But the powers that be have a much better idea than we do. They know what it is, and they know that they want to ascend there without facing any judgment, okay? Do what thou wilt is the whole of their law, okay? And that's what they want to do. And so they're doing all these science things, which, you know, most of the scientists are even deceived through the magic of math that Satan has been working on for thousands of years. You go back 500 years when the real sorcerers gained all this sudden knowledge of how the earth is actually going around the sun at 66,000 miles an hour with no parallax at all, right? It's ridiculous on its face. And these black holes, I believe, could have something to do with the portals that Enoch is talking about. That's all I'm saying. And they want to find a way that they can control something referring to the sun and the moon, so that they can change something referring to the sun and the moon. I mean, that would be one heck of a deception if they could figure a way, you know, based on these portals. I mean, when we see eclipses and the like, there's no accident why the moon and the sun are exactly the same size and all these various things. And Enoch spells it all out, but I don't really fully understand it. But I understand enough to know that nothing is going into outer space. It's just not happening. Period. What we see is something far beyond what most people can even imagine. But if you look at it from a spiritual, biblical point of view, you know that there's a spiritual war going on above you, and it's manifesting itself in the earth through all these evils and lusts and all this darkness that people are talking about now, days of darkness. They want to be able to make days of darkness. The evil ones would love to be able to create 3 days of darkness, because that would just allow them to fool the world. I mean, these are the things they're up to, the devices they're devising. It goes to that depth. So, you know, you got to just keep these things in mind. Nothing they tell you is what it seems. It's just unfortunately that way. And most of them are deceived. So you got to pray for them. You got to pray that they come to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ and know that they can't figure this stuff out with all their PhDs and math certificates. It's all a big lie. You can't lean on our own carnal understanding. But they're going to keep trying. You better believe it. And they'll take as many of us down with them as they can. So always be armored up. That's all I can tell you. It is of paramount importance. All of this stuff, it's just fakery, ritualistic magic to deceive the world. But most of the people that work at these agencies are compartmentalized and deceived, but a lot of them aren't. It is that evil, and people will go to that lengths for a job, for a paycheck. They'll sign a non-disclosure, and they'll become actors for NASA or for Space IL. This is the way it works. It's unfortunate that there's that depth of evil in the world, but this is what people need to face and turn to Christ, because he is the only truth. You're never going to figure it out on your own, and time's getting short. So I hope this made sense to someone. I truly do. And peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,